sing some spiritual hymns for Herman Cain's next appearance at the Press Club. He's going to be doing things like just a closer walk with my attorney. When the Gallup poll is called up yonder, I'll be there. And let there be pizza on earth.
I think there are a number of Democrats rooting for him to get out of this and to make it to the finish line, but it doesn't look like he's going to. I'm not sure that he was wholly ready for prime time, but he seems like a likable enough guy, and he's sure made a whole lot of new friends and contacts, and I trust that he'll convert those into some kind of personal benefits. So good luck to him.
Can come up in the polls. He's only 8%. What he's got to do to climb up to the top is harass at least three women.
I think the fact that he was far more Godspeed than Legacy. I think right now what Herman and his campaign need to do is to take a step back, focus on making sure they've got the message clear, get back out in front of this story, and then move into talking about his agenda for the country. He doesn't want to create more confusion and allow folks to sort of extrapolate what happened, what didn't happen. Set the record straight and move on.
Jump completely, as well as being a completely guy to the emotional pressure points of my book, the relationship between Jackie and Jack, and the relationship between Rose Kennedy and Jack, which apparently didn't really exist from what I can figure, which is fascinating, and cold. And I tried to find out the answer to the question that Ben Bradley got from Jack, and Ben's here, which is the question that Jack always said was the reason people read biography and even history itself. Mr. Ambassador, thank you from the United Kingdom. It still includes Northern Ireland. Anyway, Tina Urbanski is here. Where are you, Tina? Do six television shows a week, stay up all night, and do all this amazing stuff. I just want to say that the great thing about writing a book like this is to go beyond what everybody else has done and to try to get to who he was, because that's the question that President Kennedy told Ben Bradley was the reason people read these books. I wanted to know what it was like to spend time with the former president the way Ben did and George Stevens did back in the old days. And what he was right, Gillian Sorensen is here, the wife of Ted Sorensen. The amazing people that really knew the man. And I wanted to try to get to that feeling of having him in the room with you in high school and in college and then way off in the South Pacific. And one of the nicest stories I read about Jack Kennedy was from a fellow officer, Dick Carrissey, who said he was great company. And I think I read that from so many people. I was able to track back to his classmates, to where Asnod came from. It came from his headmaster. It showed, he used to quote from his hero, Dean LeBaron Russell Briggs from Harvard. And so I found that source. I found that Jack began a diary back in 46. I found his attempt at a memoir. And most important, I got to thank Helen O'Donnell, Kenny O'Donnell's daughter for giving me her father's entire 64-tape oral history of every campaign, and I was able to see what it was like to fight the good fight. He was very good, and the president can learn a lot from him. The great thing about Jack Kennedy is he combined toughness with spirit. Toughness with spirit. If you're not feared, you will not long be loved. And Jack Kennedy was feared, and Bobby was wonderful. We all would love to have a brother like Bobby Kennedy, who went in there and took the hits and administered the hits, and Jack would say, make sure he delivers and keep me out of it. And Bobby would look back at his loving brother and say, thanks, Jack, because he made him do the tough work. You're going to love this story of two brothers, one looking out for the other. You're going to love this story, but it's very sad, of Jackie and Jack. Jackie completely, utterly loved her husband. It is one thing that comes through manifestly in this book. And that's one of the wonders of life and how that developed. And she was warned on her wedding day about him. And went on, and as Bunny Mellon, her friend, said, a lot of guys came down the road that wanted her, and she was only interested in one guy, Jack Kennedy. It's a great love story. And I got to tell you, you're going to like this book. If you don't cry it after the last chapter, you're certainly not Irish. I'll just leave it at that. Thank you all for being here.